Hi, I'm Daniel. Ever wonder how to automate your written script processes while scraping? Then this web scraping with Python Selenium video is just for you. In this tutorial, we'll cover how to install Selenium and what web elements you can scrape with it. Then I'll show you how to scrape with Selenium. Let's get started. First, we need to install Selenium. If you already have it installed, you can skip this step by clicking on the next video chapter. Before we continue with this Python Selenium web scraping tutorial, we recommend using a virtual environment to create an isolated Python environment. In this Selenium Python tutorial, for beginners, we will use the venv module that ships with Python 3. Open your terminal and run. This command will create a virtual environment. To activate this virtual environment, run. Now we are ready to download Selenium. Remember that for web scraping Selenium, you would need three components: a browser, Python bindings, and a Selenium driver for your browser. The first requirement is a browser supported by Selenium. Many browsers such as Firefox, Chrome, Edge, and others are supported by Selenium. In this video, we will be using Chrome. The second component is the Selenium library for Python. This can be installed using the pip command. Execute the pip command in your terminal to download Selenium library. Lastly, you will need to install the Selenium driver for your browser. The driver enables Python to control the browser. You can head over to selenium.dev website to find links for downloading various drivers. Let's follow the link for Chrome. Before we download the driver, we need to check the version of Chrome. In this case, we have Chrome at version 104. We will download the Chrome driver for version 104. Now, update your path variable to include the location of the Chrome driver. Let's test if everything works before proceeding with this web scraping using Selenium tutorial. By the way, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons if you find this video helpful. Switch to the terminal, make sure that the virtual environment created is active, and then enter Python 3 to start the REPL. Now import the web driver from Selenium. If you see no errors, that means Selenium is installed correctly. Next, create an instance of Chrome. If you are on macOS and see an error that the Chrome driver can't be opened because Apple cannot check it for malicious software, click Show in Finder. Right-click Chrome driver and select Open. You will see a warning that macOS cannot verify the developer of the Chrome driver. Click Open and you should see the terminal showing you a message that the Chrome driver was started successfully. You can now press Ctrl-C to kill the process. Go back to the REPL and try creating an instance of Chrome. This time, you will see that Chrome opens. As a final check, call the driver.get method and enter the URL of any website of your choice. If you see any error, ensure that you entered the complete URL, including the HTTP. Finally, enter driver.quit to close the browser. We are now ready to write our Python web scraping code. Selenium offers a variety of functions to help locate elements on a page. You can find an element by its tag or attributes like ID, name, or class. You can also find links by matching the complete text or partial text. Alternatively, you can use the standard CSS selectors or XPath to find the elements. Until recently, there were different methods to cover each of those scenarios. Now there is one method, find_element, that returns one element and a plural version of the same method, find_elements, that returns a list of matching elements. These functions require two parameters to find the element that you need. The first parameter is one of the attributes of the by class. For example, the attribute can be by class name, by CSS selector, by ID, and so on. The second parameter will be the value sought of your chosen attribute. For example, if you decide to use the attribute by class name, you would be putting the actual class name in the second parameter. Let's take a closer look at all of these functions with a practical example. Here's what we're going to do. We will open the bookstoscrape.com website, click on the humor section, and extract information about books such as title, price, stock availability. Let's start with the imports. We will begin with importing Chrome and Chrome options from the selenium.webdriver module. Then we will import the by class from the selenium.webdriver.commonby module. Now, let's create the structure of our code. First, let's create a getData function. We will call this function from the main function and send the URL to this function. The getData function will return the scraped data as a list. In the getData function, create an instance of Chrome options and save in the browser options variable. Let's set the headless property to true so that the Chrome browser remains hidden when we run the script. Now create an object of Chrome, passing in the options parameter to browser options. Save this object to the variable driver. Call the driver.get method and send the URL to this function. This method will load the URL in the browser. End this function by calling driver.quit. Also update this website URL in the main function. We can now write the code between driver.get and driver.quit. Let's quickly open the website and copy the link text. Now call the driver.find_element method. Send the first parameter as by.link_text and the second parameter as humor. Save this element in the variable element. One thing to note here is that the variable element is web element. Web element in Selenium represents an HTML element. You can do many things with an element. For example, element text is for accessing text in the element. Element click is for clicking on the element. Element get attribute is for accessing an attribute, and element send keys is for sending a text to an input box. In this case, we will use the click method to navigate to the humor section of the website. On the next page that loads, we will find books and run a loop on these books to extract information. Right-click a book and click inspect. Examine the HTML markup. We can see that each book is contained in an article element with the class.product_pod. The CSS selector for this container for a book is product_pod. We can now call the find_elements method. Use the by.css_selector as the first parameter and the CSS selector as product_pod as the second parameter. Remember that find_elements is the plural variant of findElement method. It returns a list of web elements instead of one web element. Each item in this list can again accept find_element methods. It's time to create the CSS selectors. Right-click any book name and select inspect. The complete book name is in the title attribute of the anchor tag. The selector is H3 more than A. Similarly, the selector for price is price_color. The selector for stock is instock.availability. First, create an empty list and call it data. Now, write the loop and start with extracting the book information. For book, in books. The title, price, and stock are objects of the type web element. Getting prices and stock availability is easy. We can use the text attribute. If we want to extract the complete book name, it is safer for this website to extract the title attribute. For this, we can use the get_attribute method and pass in the title as the attribute name. Create a dictionary with the name book_item and keep the keys as title, price, and stock. Append this data dictionary to the list data. Data.append, open brackets, book_item, close brackets. As the last step, return this data variable after driver.quit. Congratulations, you have written a Selenium web scraper. If you want to learn more about relevant topics, head straight to these videos explaining proxies and lead generation with the help of web scraping. Now, let's see the results. To see the scrape results, add a print statement to the main function. Finally, run the script from the terminal. You will see that the data is printed on the terminal. Alternatively, we can save the data as a file that can be opened in Excel. For more information, click on this info card to watch a tutorial on how to extract scraped data to Excel. If you found this Python Selenium tutorial helpful, like this video and subscribe to our channel to not miss other exciting content. Thank you, and see you next time.